Are you thinking about becoming a pilot? You've probably heard the term checkride thrown around. What exactly is a checkride, and why is it so crucial in aviation? In this video from Epic Flight Academy, we're going to learn what a checkride is. Why do pilots need to take them? How do they differ from another flight activity or exam? And what check airmen look for when evaluating their students? Before we begin, be sure to like this video and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy for more aviation information and tips from aviation experts. Let's dive in.
My name is Ray Altmann. I am the Chief Flight Instructor at Epic Flight Academy. I've been with Epic for 8 years. A checkride, also known as a practical test, is an evaluation of a pilot's skill in reference to the airman certification standards. And you must take a checkride to prove that you can hold that certificate or rating, which allows you to do different privileges as a pilot. Other than a student pilot certificate, every other pilot certificate or rating will require a checkride. That's from private pilot all the way to ATP or airline transport pilot.
A checkride, officially known as the FAA practical exam, is the final examination every pilot must pass to earn a specific certificate or rating, such as the private pilot license or instrument rating. These are conducted by a designated pilot examiner who evaluates whether you meet all the FAA's requirements for certification. Think of it as a major step forward in your flight training, demonstrating your readiness to fly safely and competently. The checkride consists of two main components, the oral examination and a flight test.
So your typical checkride is gonna consist of two major portions, the oral portion, which is usually somewhere around 1 to 3 hours, where you're gonna cover all the knowledge-based content of your certificate rating. And then you'll have a flight portion, which is demonstrating the landings, maneuvers, and emergencies associated with that certificate rating.
In an oral examination, you'll undergo an oral exam where the DPE assesses your knowledge on various topics, including aviation regulations, flight planning and weather interpretation, aircraft systems and performance, and emergency procedures. This segment ensures you have a solid theoretical foundation to make informed decisions during flight. Once your oral exam is complete, you'll take your flight test, where you'll proceed to the practical flight portion. Here, you'll demonstrate your ability to perform specific maneuvers and procedures, such as takeoffs and landings, navigation and instrument proficiency, emergency operations, and adherence to air traffic control instructions. The DPE observes to confirm you can operate the aircraft safely and in accordance with FAA standards.
An instructor knows when their student's ready by multiple ways. If they're meeting the airman certification standards, that's number one. If their confidence in safety and aeronautical decision-making is high quality, that would be the number two way to tell. And just overall abilities as a pilot and comfortability as a pilot, flying the plane, meeting the standards.
To prepare effectively, here's what a student pilot should do. Study diligently. Utilize study guides and resources to reinforce your knowledge. Teaching the material to someone else can also enhance your understanding. Mock check rides. Engage in practice tests with your instructor to simulate the check ride environment and receive constructive feedback. Rest and nutrition. Ensure you're well rested and have eaten adequately before the test to maintain focus and performance.
To prepare for a checkride, I would definitely encourage everyone to look at the airman certification standards. That tells you exactly what you're going to be assessed on. All of the FAA documents, such as the Pilot Handbook of Aeronautical Knowledge, Airplane Flying Handbook, sectional charts, chart supplements, the list goes on, but any FAA approved document, very important to review. Myself, I suffer from test anxiety, and I am pretty familiar with being nervous before checkrides. So the things I've done that has helped me is get a good night's sleep, eat a great breakfast, show up a couple hours early so you have time to just relax and you're not rushed to set up. And if you do have the chance to ever meet the designated practical examiner that you're going with and just a quick conversation, say hi and let them know you have a checkride coming up, oftentimes helps calm the nerves of realizing that they're just a normal human being doing their job.
Not passing a checkride can be disheartening, but it's not the end of your aviation aspirations. If you fail any portion, here is what to expect. notice of disapproval. The DPE will issue this document outlining areas needing improvement. Targeted retraining. This will show you where to focus on the specified areas with your instructor to address deficiencies. Retesting. You can retake the failed portion after additional instruction. Many pilots have faced setbacks and gone on to have successful careers.
So it's very common for students to fail at least one of their checkrides throughout their training. The biggest thing that I would encourage them is to stay positive and look at that moment of failure as a moment of learning and figuring out what did they do incorrectly and appropriately then retrain and then demonstrate the appropriate pathway. When getting hired, airlines will ask how many failures you have on a checkride. That doesn't necessarily mean if you've ever failed a checkride, you don't get a job. What they want to see is how did you overcome that failure and become a better pilot?
To enhance your chances of passing, here are some tips. Consistent practice. Treat every training flight as if it's the checkride to build consistent habits. Know your examiner. Familiarize yourself with the DPE's expectations by speaking with peers who have tested with them. Organized documentation. Ensure all required documents are complete and readily accessible. Clear communication. Articulate your thoughts and actions clearly during the exam. Stay calm. Approach the checkride with confidence, viewing it as an opportunity to showcase your skills. Remember, thorough preparation and a positive mindset are key to success with your checkride.
Some myths about checkrides that I've heard would be that the DPE wants to see you fail. They don't want to pass you. That's not true. It's quite the opposite. They need to see a safe, competent pilot, but they're not there to fail you. If anything, they're there to pass you until you fail yourself.
Embarking on a checkride is a significant milestone in your pilot journey. With diligent preparation and the right mindset, you're well on your way to earning your wings and furthering your pilot career. If you found this video helpful, share your thoughts or questions in the comments below. Give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more aviation insights from Epic Flight Academy.